क्लास 7 सब्जेक्ट सोशल साइंस सिविक्स चैप्टर नंबर 1 ऑन इक्वालिटी। नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट न्यू चैप्टर फ्रॉम सिविक्स चैप्टर नंबर 1 ऑन इक्वालिटी। इन दिस चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट व्हाट इज इक्वालिटी, व्हाट डज इट मींस। सेकंड टॉपिक इज द स्टोरी ऑफ कांता। थर्ड राइट टू वोट। Fourth, universal adult franchise. Fifth, kinds of equality. Sixth, Jhutan, a story of Dalit's life. Sixth, dignity, equality in Indian democracy. Issues of equality in other democracies, civil rights movement, and challenge of democracy. These are the topics that are covered in this chapter. So we are starting on equality. India is a democracy. In the class 6th book, we looked at the key elements of the democratic government. As all of you know about the word democracy, the first word is democracy. So can you tell me about the democracy? Okay, I am going to tell you about the democracy. According to Abraham Lincoln, you know about the Abraham Lincoln. According to Abraham Lincoln, democracy is the government of the people, for the people, and by the people. So the word democracy also means that democracy is a form of government in which all citizens or all eligible citizens means the citizen who have attained the age of 18 years have an equal opportunity or say in the decisions that affect their lives. Means the decisions that are taken by the government, if these decisions affect their lives, so the common people have the power or are eligible to say about this. And the common people hold political power. And we are the common people. As we are the common people, so we have the power to hold politics, and can rule either directly or through elected representatives. And we have a power to hold the politics with the elected representatives, because in the democracy, common people or citizen have a right to vote. With this right to vote, we have a right to elect our representative. So with this representative, we have directly or indirectly can rule the politics or can rule the government. So now we are going to learn about another topic in this chapter. These includes people's participation. And key elements of democratic government are, first, people's participation means through elections, the resolution of conflicts, and the equality and justice. Resolution of conflicts is also there, equality is there, and justice. From this, equality. Now we are discussing about the equality. Equality is a key feature of democracy and influences all aspects of its functioning. In this chapter, you will read more about equality. What it is, why it is important in democracy, or whether or not everyone is equal in India. Let's begin. Now, all these questions are cleared by the help of the story of Kanta. Now, here are some characters showing here. Manjeet Kaur, a teacher. Teja Singh, trader. Girish Rao, student. Kanta Devi, a domestic worker. Main character of the story. Sujata, also another domestic worker. Abdul Rahman, artisan. Shabnam Bano, housewife. Gracil, consultant. Isak, government officer. Ruksana Mirza, media person. Yograj, unemployed. Ashok Jain, industrialist. These are the main characters of this Kanta's story. Now, on election day, story begins with the election day. On election day, Kanta and her friend Sujata are waiting to cast their votes. Means Sujata and Kanta are in a queue and they are waiting for their chance to cast their vote because the day is of election. Isn't it good, Suja, that we can all vote as equal citizens of our country? Even Jain Sahib is standing in the line with us. Yes, Sujata says yes. This is because of equality in India. Now, go on, Kanta. It's your turn. Sujata says, "Go, Kanta. Please go on. It's your turn. I will vote for the candidate who has promised to bring pipe water to our area." And Kanta thought that I will vote only for that person. That person who has promised to bring the water or the water pipelines to their houses because they don't have the proper water supply at their houses. Now, on the next page, afterwards, we will see you later, Kanta. Yes, Namaste, Sahib. Now, Jain Sahib say, we will see you later, Kanta. And she says, Namaste, Sahib. Now, next. Gudiya has been running fever. Kanta and Sujata discussing about the Gudiya, that she has running fever and I have to take her to the hospital. But I will have to finish the work at Sahib's house first. Kanta says my daughter has been suffering from fever. I have to take her to the doctor. But first of all, I have to do the domestic work at Sahib's house and ask for some advance. And she say that I am also asking for some advance to the Jain Sahib. Now Kanta is at her house. Here have some of this. You will feel better. And when I get back in the evening, we will go to the hospital. Okay. She says to her daughter that please take this. When I get back, I will take you to the hospital. Now, it's no wonder that Gudiya falls ill. Often the basti is never clean. So the first or the main cause of the Gudiya's fall ill was the basti was very dirty. That their basti was very dirty. Now make sure to do corners properly. Here, madam says, please clearly wash or whip out the corners properly. Here, your advance, Kanta. And ma'am says, take your advance, but don't make a habit of it. And with allegation that, please don't make this habit to take advance. No, ma'am. That evening, just few more minutes, Betty. And she says to her daughter, that please few minutes. Jain madam and Jain sahib may stand in line to vote, but they never have to do it when their children are sick. And here the Kanta thought that they are waiting like us or the common peoples in the line or in the queue when they also want to cast their vote. But in the hospital, they are not waiting like us when their children are sick. So here the differences occurs in her mind. Now, next topic is equal right to vote. As we see that due to this difference, bringing the Kanta's mind, now we are discussing about equal right to vote. Means at the place of the voting center, all peoples are equal. But in the hospital, are all not equal.